kidding me?
I am Ian Martin Allison for SBL, and today we are looking at the beautifully simple yet deceptively complex playing, approach, and sound of Mr. Pino Palladino on John Mayer's 2006 release, Continuum. So before we dive in track by track into Continuum, a little word about gear. Today, I am using my 1965 Fender P bass with old flatwound strings, and typically I have the cover, the pickup cover on this bass, but for Pino, right, he has this palm muting thing that we're gonna talk about, and the cover totally gets in the way. Then I am running through a bit of compression from the Origin Effects Cali 76 into a subtle B15 model in the Line 6 HX Stomp, then followed up by the Noble Preamp DI. First up is Waiting on the World to Change. We're gonna take a look at the last chorus and this unbelievable fill that Pino plays. So Waiting on the World to Change, the chorus, a super simple progression. 1, 6, 4, 1. And Pino doesn't typically do that, like that bell sound that walks up back to the one. Like occasionally he'll do it, but he's very restrained there, which I really like. But then that fill, let's take a look at that. Oh, it's just so beautiful and fits right in the gap between the vocal. One day a generation. And then the fill. Also, oh my gosh, excuse my terrible singing voice, but I really do think that melody, understanding what's happening with the vocal, is so critical. So if you're singing it, humming it, whatever, it will allow you to build your parts around the vocal, which is really at the crux of what makes a great session musician. Okay, so let's slow that down a little bit. So what's going on with that fill, we get to an E minor, right? And Pino starts on the fifth degree of the E and then plays down this E minor scale lick from the G, G flat or F sharp to E. And then he repeats that motif, essentially an octave lower. And then landing on the sixth chord here before we get back to the E minor. Next up is I Don't Trust Myself, and Steve Jordan, who co-produced and played drums on this record, had the great idea of bringing Willie Weeks into the studio to play on this one. Now, if you don't know Willie Weeks, stop what you're doing and check out Donny Hathaway's record, his live record. There is an incredible bass solo that we should probably profile here on SBL on the last tune on that record called Everything is Everything. It is just a masterpiece of how to build a motivic solo over a long time, over one chord. It's masterful. Steve Jordan knew that, brings in Willie Weeks, and instead of like vibing each other out or sending somebody home, Steve Jordan had the great idea of having them both play on this tune, I Don't Trust Myself. So there are two bass parts on this tune, and I have a great live recording pulled up. David Labriere, De La, is playing the bottom part, but Pino is on the other side of the stage playing the high part. Check it out. So De La is playing this. From that A to C to a high F, then A to C, low F. Holding it down. I'm not the man I used to be lately. And then Pino is doing all this fun high stuff. Willie plays this short long figure that De La is playing on this live recording, right? And it's essentially a short long eighth note figure. All that means is I'm playing short long, short long, short long, short long, and I'm muting the eighth notes by dropping this hand, my right hand, down on the string to mute the note, and then lifting just slightly. So slowly, short long, short long. tempo. Then, of course, Pino comes in and he's playing this more like claw grip. This is so cool. Pino does this thing where he palm mutes the bass, right? So he runs his tone back a bit and palm mutes a lot of the time. And that lets him get these sort of figures where he's playing tenths. So he's playing a minor tenth here on the A. And all a tenth is a third, the A and the C, the A and its minor third, C, but the C is up an octave, okay? So he's playing A and a C together. Then he's playing a C and an E together, C major, and then an F and an A together, F major, right? But he's just doing it short like this. And then occasionally maybe, almost sounds like this kind of vibe. But they're a little more subtle than that because they're on a P bass with flats. So his part is. And on the record, he stays pretty faithful to that. But I've heard, like, as he got out playing it live a little bit more, he starts to do stuff like this. Right, where he's pulling off that C, pulling off from the E to the D. Pretty cool. It is just a wonderful part put together. And then of course, now Sean Hurley gets out on the road with Mayer and he puts both the pieces together, right? So you can do both. If you hold down the bottom short long and then play on the top, like holding down the bottom with your thumb and then playing the top notes with your index or middle finger, you can do both. Next up is Belief, and check out how Pino takes what sounds almost like a fill and turns it into a part in this chorus. Ooh, check that line out. Even just that, one E and a two E and just that syncopation. And I love that this part becomes this motif, right, that he always comes back to. Almost like if you play that figure, that gives you then permission to almost improvise the groove a little bit more in the other parts of the bar. Like Pino doesn't play this the same way here that he did on the record, right? So as long as you have this figure, that's the signature of the bar. And then things are up for grabs in the second half. Next up is Gravity. And listen to Pino support. And then when there is a fill idea on this live performance that I found, it is beautiful. It adds to the performance. It doesn't draw your attention away from the tune. It enhances the tune. And that is an art. Gravity is working against me. And if you listen to the top of this tune, it is all about support. He's playing long notes. He's still intentional about his muting, but he's not doing anything like tricky and fancy and trying to cut off his notes right with the snare that Steve Jordan's doing. He's not going, gravity, right? It's like, it's more like this, gravity. Occasionally he'll leave space, but just dig in and critically listen to him on this tune. It's just masterful. And what he's doing again, that palm muted approach, he's putting his hand down on the string and using his thumb. And then you have all this access to muting. You can make the notes long by hitting them and kind of letting go of the mute, or you can make them really short and kind of thumpy, right? And just let me show you one fill that he plays that is just magic in this performance. X and Y sounds good and wants to stay like a one half could. Oh, this is so cool. When he gets to the D chord, listen to this fill he plays. Like a one half could. It's wanting more. Oh, so beautiful. D major chord. That jump is just so unexpected and cool, right? So D major plays the pentatonic, second, third, fifth, sixth. So, you know, from this. We've all played that a million times, but then this jump. Oh, and then that masterful fall down the five and the octave of D to the B flat, the next change. So good. Pino, an animal. Before we move on to the last tune, if you want me to go through any other record, list it in the comments below. I go through, I read that stuff. I want to know what you want from this channel, right? And while you're there, if you've enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. And also, if you're saying to yourself, this stuff is going by too quickly on the screen, I would love to have a beautiful PDF workbook of all of these tunes and exercises. We got you. The incredible team at SBL has put together a workbook for you that you can download absolutely free. It's in the description. And finally, Vultures, and this has to be without a doubt one of my favorite Pino, Steve Jordan, John Mayer grooves of all time. Here is a great performance of them doing it as the trio. Check it out. Just roots and fifths with his palm muted technique. Ooh, and John sounds so good. Oh, and he waits to the end to play that cool figure. This performance is full of amazing Pinoisms. Let's get through a couple of them. First of all, that main groove. Now this is about precision, this thing, right? So like playing and really cutting off with snares. So being really aware of backbeat. One and two. On beat two, really letting Steve Jordan's snare like occupy the space in the mix. So getting out, not holding your note over beat two, not one, two, right? It's one, two. But then this thing he plays at the end, oh my gosh. So cool, right? This syncopated figure. And then the A with the 10th, sliding up to the B with the 10th. Also, in this trio configuration, Pino has this unique opportunity to take up more space because there's no keys, because there's no rhythm guitar player, right? He supports John in a different way than he does on the record. And it's so cool to contrast the two. So check out Pino's like double stop support in this John Mayer guitar solo. Okay, come here. It's time for a sneaky bass lesson. If we're thinking about this tune as in the key of E, A becomes the four chord and is the Lydian mode. What Lydian means, all Lydian is an A major scale in this context, but with a sharp four. So when we get to that part of the tune, we're playing an A. Pino does this thing to support. He's playing an A on the bottom. And then he's playing an A and the E, then the A, the E flat or D sharp, right? And then the A and its third C sharp. Then back to the main groove. And again, it's a part. It doesn't sound like noodling, right? He really knows what he's doing. And then there is a fill at the end of this tune that is just masterful. We have to look at it. Here he goes. is. I'm gonna slow it down, right? Check it out. But it's swung, it's so groovy. And he actually plays it with this claw grip, right? With the palm mute. Hey, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully now you have a better idea of how to approach Pino Palladino's unbelievable playing on John Mayer's 2006 record, Continuum. Because of this record, I really started to think about walking that razor wire between being creative on one side and supportive on the other, and always the balancing act that I perceive Pino is always thinking about. Being creative, but also never at the expense of the song. So thank you so much for watching. I have been Ian Martin Allison for SBL. I'll see you in the shed.